Let's have some fun. Welcome back. If you're new here, my name is Shane, and I'm currently sharing my favorite songs on my Spotify playlist. In addition to that, I share some of my favorite YouTube music videos. And I also have been listening to some new music to try to broaden my horizons a little bit as well. Today, I have one of my favorite songs, and this is the song Black by Pearl Jam. This is a live performance off of MTV Unplugged. It's a great live performance, and it's definitely one of my favorites for sure. Pearl Jam had been out for a few years, but they just had success with their album 10 the year prior to this appearance, and they had been on tour to promote that album. In 1992, they made this appearance on MTV Unplugged. I think you'll enjoy it. Let's have a listen. Love these Unplugged performances. Yeah, I love the way he, all the little inflections and pauses that he has throughout the song. Just a lot of just passion and emotion behind it. Of course, the subject matter is one that lends itself to that. Your world just turning to black after you've lost somebody that you really loved. So the lyrics are also just incredible, but I really like the way he just really pours himself into the song and puts some just emotion behind it and intensity. I'll back it up here a second, but yeah, there's another verse. He sees people, kids playing and having fun, but he just feels emptiness inside, and It's just, and he's amazed by how quickly that can change, how you can go from being on top of the world to being on the bottom of the world in terms of your feelings. So, just great imagery, and again, so much passion behind his lyrics and his voice. Whoa, that raspiness too. Love that quality. Yeah, so I'm gonna back it up here just a little bit, 'cause that's probably the best line of the song right there. Wow, yeah, I mean, that's something I think we've all felt at one time in our lives, or at least most people have at least. So just to have that put in a song like that, just as I said, just the combination of the lyrics, instrumentation, everything is just really makes that song stand out. And then just his performance, on top of that. Interesting story. So a couple years back, I had actually had a chance to see Pearl Jam. They were doing their tour. They were going to be in Seattle, playing at home in Seattle, and a local radio station had an offer to get free tickets to the concert, free airfare, and all expenses paid, trip to Seattle to see the concert and back home. So I was caller, whatever, caller 9 or whatever you had to be to get to become a finalist for the contest. And the contest finale took place at a local bar, and we went to the bar, and the way they did it was they had a deck of 52 cards, and on each card they had a Pearl Jam song written down. The title of a Pearl Jam song written down. And so you drew a card when you came in, and you had to one of the songs from Pearl Jam's music library, basically. And then what they did was they put all of those 52 songs in an iPod. At the time, it was an iPod. And they just hit shuffle and started playing through the songs. And as soon as you heard your song, you were out. So the last song played, whoever had that card would win the trip. And I had no doubt that I was not going to win. So I didn't really expect to win at all. I just thought it would be a good evening and that kind of thing. So my wife and I waited all night. Songs kept eliminating people, and they weren't playing the whole song. They'd play a few seconds of the song or a few minutes maybe. And pretty soon there's 26 people left, so I'm in the top half, right? Pretty soon it's top 20, top 15, top 10. At this point, I'm like still thinking, man, top 10, that's crazy. That's crazy to make it that far. Still didn't expect that I was going to win anything, but I just was like just surprised that I made it that far. Then it's top 9, top 8, 7, 6, 5. I'm in the top 5, and now I'm starting to think, could this really happen? Still only a 20% chance, right? Still not likely. But I was thinking, man, top 5, that's just crazy. And they started slowing things down at that point. But pretty soon it was 4 people left. And then it got down to 3 people left. And they basically asked the 3 of us that were left to come up there. And I couldn't believe it. Still, top 3. At that point, I thought I might actually have a shot of winning this. So they took our names and everything. And I think the first place got the concert, the tickets, the airline tickets, and all of that, hotel stay. Second place, you got the new CD. I think it was Backspacer at the time. Anyway, and then third place, you didn't get anything. At that point, I again, part of me was thinking there's no way I'm gonna win anything, but then part of me was thinking that I actually had a chance. They played the next song, and it wasn't mine, and another person got eliminated. I was like, holy crap. At that point, I had convinced myself that I was destined to win this thing. And so it was just me and the one other guy. And whichever song got played next, whoever song that was eliminated, meaning the person left would be the winner. And they played the next song, and the second I heard the first part of the song at all, I knew it was my song. I got eliminated. So, made it all the way to the top two, which is almost worse than had I gotten eliminated early on because I had to stay there all night just to see if I would win and then ended up not winning. I think I never even went back and got the CD, honestly. But so close. Just a little interesting story about a time that I almost won a trip to see Pearl Jam in Seattle. So, anyway, hope you've enjoyed this. If this is the kind of content you enjoy, be sure to like and subscribe. If you have other suggestions for me on great live performances, leave those in the comments. And I am keeping a list of those so that I can kind of mix those in with my own favorites. So I'm going to do at least one or two viewer requests a week in addition to that. And also, if the other thing I'll mention is if videos get blocked for some reason, in most cases I'll be putting those up on Patreon for free, at least here in the beginning when I don't have a huge following yet. I'm going to be putting those on Patreon for free so that you can see the uncut version and unedited versions. If you feel so inclined to support me on Patreon, I'm going to use that money towards new equipment. And a portion of those proceeds will go to our local United Way here in my community. So, in any event, thanks for watching. And until next time, have a great evening.